Fine. Hey.
Good morning. Is this Kirk Franklin?
This is he.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
Hi, Kirk Franklin. I'm Belder Beebe. You're on the Belder Beebe Show right here in Dallas, Texas on KKBI. Thanks for joining us.
What's going on? What's up, hometown?
Ah, Dallas is a wonderful place, isn't it?
Yeah, but the traffic today is crazy.
Oh, it is. Well, that's always crazy. You know, we're the fastest growing city in the nation. We have 1,000 people a week that move to Dallas.
There's 1,000 people a week that move to Dallas?
Not even Texas. Houston is bigger, but 1,000 a week move to Dallas, Texas. They love our weather. They love our people, Kirk Franklin. We're the nicest people on the planet.
Well, what we're going to do is we're going to ask those 1,000 people a week, I want them to turn on to Dish 116 and check out the American Bible Challenge. It comes on GSN Thursdays at 9 p.m. Eastern. So 1,000 people a week, I want you to tune in and check your boy out on the American Bible Challenge.
I'm so glad you're on there. I watched it a little bit with Jeff Foxworthy, and then he had a couple of people I knew from Dallas on it. Mm-hmm. I always thought it was a great idea. Now, Kirk, I know that you were raised by, I think, your aunt, mm-hmm. and she felt that you had to go to church and learn to play music. Well, could you be a good contestant on American Bible Challenge?
I would be an okay contestant.
Me too.
That's all I would be is just okay.
Too.
Because I thought I knew.
Favorite.
Yeah, like there were some things I thought I knew, but then after being on the show and watching the show, it's like, okay, I'm a little dumb. But, you know, it's a fun show. And what's so cool about the show is that you don't have to know much about the Bible to still find a place to be entertained. I think that it's a very entertaining show. And it's a show that does a good job of blending pop culture with what's happening in this old book and really try to find a way to make it really cool and fresh. And they do a good job of it.
They do. They really do. And I'd rather laugh at something that someone missed about the Bible than laugh about something that has no value.
That's good. That's good. I like how you say that. And then they brought me on, and I'm so excited to be part of it. And at first, I didn't know how it was going to fit when they invited me to be part of it. So when I got the call from GSN, I didn't really know how it was going to fit. But I'm so glad that I did it, and I'm so glad to be a part of it now. So I'm just very glad to see people excited about a show, like you said, that brings inspiration, brings value, and entertainment. And now good music. So it's
will
a good thing.
You do any kind of performing for us, or is that not your role?
On the show?
On the show.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes. So what I do is I'm there with the choir, and I keep it real crunk. I keep it crazy, and I keep it fun and entertaining. And I bring the hot sauce to the show. So that's I do.
That's going to be great. Let me ask you. Doing my research, I saw that you and your wife were on Jet Magazine talking about balancing family and work.
Okay.
What did you tell us? What do we need to know? Because, you know, that's a challenge for America's family. And
yeah.
I think it's synonymous with talking about the American Bible Challenge because it's about family.
Well, here's the biggest thing that I would say to anybody is that you cannot be afraid to lose the deal. That a lot of times we sacrifice our families because we think that if I don't go out there and get it, that I'm going to miss my opportunity. I'm going to tell you that if it's for you, you will not lose the deal. You cannot compromise your first call, which is your family, by trying to chase after dreams or even money or success or fame. Because success for me is making sure that my children know me as daddy and my wife knows me as her hero and her protector. If I fail at those things, it doesn't matter what my bank account looks like or it doesn't matter what the trophies look like because I failed because my kids need to know that something is bigger than just trying to make it.
Did you tell us that also in the blueprint, A Plan for Living Above the Storms? Did you kind of put that little nugget in there?
Yes,
for us?
I did tell you about that in the blueprint, and I like how you just made that transition, the blueprint, book, and stories. Yeah.
Well, I did read it.
Yeah, well, thank you for reading the book. Thank you for listening to the music. Thank you for watching me on the Great American Bible Challenge. Thank you for watching me on Sunday Best. Thank you for letting me detail your car at Kirk's Detail Shop. I mean, just whatever you know me from, just thank you for letting me be part of your life. And, you know, and hopefully you can check me out even more, even on GSN, you know, watching me do my thing.
That's right. When do you want us to watch it? When does it come on the American Bible Challenge?
It comes on Thursdays, 9 p.m. Eastern on GSN. It comes on Dish 116, and you can check it out. This is season 2 of the American Bible Challenge. Again, Thursdays, 9 p.m. Eastern on GSN, Dish 116.
Kurt Franklin, we love you. We adore you. We really do.
I love you.
And thank you for stopping by the Bounder BB Show.
Thank you so much.
We look forward to your next great adventure.
Thank you. I appreciate it.